Welcome back, everyone. Today we learn about anatomy of the digestive system. We will study in detail the various parts of the digestive system. First, we have the mouth. The pH in the mouth is around pH 7.
The physical digestion occurring in the mouth are as follows.
The teeth carry out mastication, which is the chewing and grinding of food. The tongue rolls food substances into a food bolus. And the salivary glands secrete saliva.
The chemical digestion that occurs at that saliva contains water, which facilitate hydrolysis of starch, mucus, and enzyme, which is amylase.
Next, we have the esophagus.
It also has a pH of 7, and most importantly, peristalsis is occurring here.
Peristalsis is the alternate rhythmic contraction and relaxation of the circular and longitudinal muscle along the alimentary canal to push food bolus forward.
Behind the food bolus, as we can see in this diagram, the circular muscle contracts to narrow the lumen, preventing food from moving backwards.
And the longitudinal muscle relaxes to elongate as circular muscle contracts.
At the food bolus, as we can see in this diagram,
the circular muscle relaxes to dilate the lumen to accommodate the bolus.
And the longitudinal muscle contract to shorten the path to increase speed of bolus movement.
Following the esophagus, we have the stomach.
The pH in the stomach is 2, a rather acidic environment. The physical digestion occurring here is peristalsis in the stomach wall, which churns and break up the food. Partly digested food becomes liquefied form, forming chyme. The chemical digestion that occurs are as follow.
The stomach secretes gastric juice, which contains hydrochloric acid, HCl, and enzymes.
The function of HCl is that it kills bacteria and other foreign particles.
It provides acidic pH for the action of gastric enzymes.
And it stops action of enzyme from the mouth. The liver produces bile 24/7.
The gallbladder
stores bile that is produced by the liver
and secretes bile when needed into the small intestine. The pancreas secretes pancreatic juice into the small intestine.
And this pancreatic juice contains alkaline salts and enzyme. The alkaline salts, sodium hydrogen carbonate, increases the pH of acidic chyme to pH 8.
Next, the small intestine. It has a pH of 7.8 to 8. The small intestine comprises of the duodenum, jejunum, and ileum.
It contains villi for absorption. The duodenum receive pancreatic juice from the pancreas and bile from the gallbladder.
All three parts of the small intestine carry out digestion and absorption of nutrients. Lastly, we have the large intestine.
The large intestine comprises of cecum, appendix, which is attached to the cecum, colon, rectum, and anus.
The cecum and appendix have lost its function over the years as human evolved.
The rectum stores feces temporarily.
And the anus allows feces to exit the body.
The colon absorbs water and mineral salts from the undigested food material.
That's all for today. Thank you for the effort to learn with me. Stay tuned for more interesting lessons. See you next time. Bye-bye.